Good morning. Let's find the power delivered by the force of gravity to a pumpkin dropped out of a second-story window.
Flippin' physics!
Bo, could you please read the problem, and Billy, could you please translate?
An 8.53-kilogram pumpkin is dropped from a height of 8.91 meters.
Please stop. Mass equals 8.53 kilograms... Displacement in the y direction is negative 8.91 meters, and the initial velocity in the y direction is zero.
Bo, please keep reading.
What is the power delivered by the force of gravity?
Power delivered by the force of gravity equals question mark, and let's write out the equations for power. Power delivered by the force of gravity equals work due to the force of gravity divided by change in time, and it also equals force of gravity times velocity times cosine theta.
Bo?
Okay, we are at, what is the power delivered by the force of gravity? A, over the whole displacement of the pumpkin, B, right after the pumpkin is dropped, and C, right before the pumpkin strikes the ground.
Okay, we're solving for three different powers delivered by the force of gravity. Part A is for the whole time, part B is initial, and part C is final.
Correct. There are three answers for the power delivered by the force of gravity to the pumpkin. Part A is for the whole time. Part B is right after the pumpkin is dropped, or initial. And part C is right before the pumpkin strikes the ground, or final. Bobby, which parts of the problem are asking for average power, and which are asking for instantaneous power?
Well, average is over a time period, and part A has a time period of the entire time the pumpkin is in free fall. So part A is asking for average power. Instantaneous power is at a specific time. And both parts B and C are at specific times, the initial and final points. So both parts B and C are asking for instantaneous power.
Very nice, Bobby. Bo, could you please start solving part A?
Well, let's start with the equation power equals work over change in time. And that's the work done by the force of gravity, so we can substitute in for the work done by the force of gravity times displacement times cosine theta. And then we can substitute mass times acceleration due to gravity for the force of gravity. We know the mass of the pumpkin is 8.53 kilograms. The acceleration due to gravity is 9.81 meters per second squared. And the displacement in the y direction of the pumpkin is negative 8.91 meters.
Hang on. Remember, in the work equation, you use the magnitude of the force and the magnitude of the displacement.
Right. So it's positive 8.91 meters times the cosine of, well, the force of gravity is down and the displacement of the pumpkin is down. So the angle between those two directions is zero. So the cosine of 0 degrees all divided by... We don't know the change in time. We need to figure out the change in time.
Right. Billy, could you please find change in time?
While the pumpkin is in free fall, we already have the displacement and initial velocity. Oh, the acceleration in the y direction equals negative little g, or negative 9.81 meters per second squared. We can use the uniformly accelerated motion equation, displacement in the y direction equals velocity initial in the y direction times change in time, plus 1/2 times acceleration in the y direction times change in time squared. Substituting in numbers gives us negative 8.91 equals 0 times change in time, plus 1/2 times negative 9.81 times change in time squared. We can multiply by 2 and divide by negative 9.81, and the negatives cancel out, and we can take the square root of the whole equation to give us change in time equals the square root of 8.91 times 2 divided by 9.81, which is 1.34778 seconds, which we can substitute into the power equation from before. Power delivered by the force of gravity equals... 553.193, or with three significant figures, 553. And the dimensions for power It's in joules per second and 553 watts.
Or joules per second, is the average power delivered by the force of gravity to the pumpkin the entire time the pumpkin is in free fall. In other words, on average, the Earth delivers 553 joules of energy every second to the pumpkin. Yes, Bo?
Couldn't we have solved it this way? Couldn't we have started by solving for the average velocity of the pumpkin using the equation average velocity equals displacement divided by change in time, or negative 8.91 divided by 1.34778, which is negative 6.61087 meters per second, and then plugged that into the other equation for power? Power delivered by the force of gravity equals the force of gravity times velocity average times cosine theta. Substitute in mass times acceleration due to gravity for the force of gravity. Then it's 8.53 times 9.81 times positive 6.61087. Positive because we use the magnitude of the velocity in the power equation. Times cosine of zero, which gives us 553.193 or 553 watts, which is exactly what we got before.
Yes, you can solve it either way.
Oh, good. Thanks.
Bobby, part B, the instantaneous power being delivered to the pumpkin at that initial point. In other words, right after it is dropped. Please.
Okay, let's start with the equation power equals work delivered by the force of gravity divided by change in time. So power equals force of gravity times displacement times cosine theta divided by change in time. Actually, that doesn't really make sense, does it? The displacement is the change in position of an object, and instantaneous power is at a specific time, which is only one position. You can't define displacement without two different positions, can you?
Bobby, that is correct. Power equals work over change in time will only give you average power. On the other hand, power equals force times velocity times the cosine of theta can give you average, and it can also give you instantaneous power. It just depends. If you use average velocity with the equation, you will get the average power. If you use instantaneous velocity, you will get instantaneous power. Bobby, could you please solve part B?
Okay. Power delivered by the force of gravity equals the force of gravity times the initial velocity in the y direction times cosine theta. However, the initial velocity of the pumpkin is zero, so the initial instantaneous power delivered by the force of gravity to the pumpkin is zero.
Correct, Bobby. Billy, could you please now solve part C? We're solving for the instantaneous power being delivered to the pumpkin at that final point, in other words, right before the pumpkin strikes the ground.
Okay, we can use the same equation Bobby just used. However, rather than substituting in the velocity initial in the y direction of the pumpkin, we will substitute in the velocity final in the y direction of the pumpkin. So we need the pumpkin's final velocity in the y direction. It's still in free fall, so we can use the uniformly accelerated motion equation. Velocity final in the y direction squared equals the initial velocity in the y direction squared plus 2 times the acceleration in the y direction times displacement in the y direction. The initial velocity is zero, and we can take the square root of the whole equation to get velocity final in the y direction equals the square root of 2 times 9.81, times negative 9.81 times negative 8.91, which equals 13.2217 meters per second. And it's negative because it's going down, and I'm smarter than my calculator. We can substitute that back into the equation we had for power, along with mass times acceleration due to gravity for the force of gravity, and we still have 8.53 times 9.81 times the positive of the 13.2217 times the cosine of it's still zero, which is 1,106.386 or 1,110 watts with three significant figures. Can I convert that over to horsepower?
Sure, Billy. Go ahead.
Okay. So we multiply by one horsepower divided by 746 watts to get 1.48369 or 1.48 horsepower. The power being delivered to the pumpkin by the force of gravity right before it strikes the ground is equal to the power that could be delivered by roughly 1.5 horses.
Very nice, everybody. Yes, Bo?
I feel like we should graph this.
Oh, makes sense, yes, to me.
Shouldn't absolutely. We keep graphing this?
Yes. Sure, absolutely. That sounds... Yeah, that's the bell. Unfortunately, we'll have to do that next time. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.
I gotta go. The chess club is meeting right after school.